The moment you feel yourself hesitate, the moment you've got one of those moments where you know that you need to, this is that moment that Lewis talks to you about where you got to step outside of your comfort zone and you've got to lean into your passion and you've got to really take some risks and you got to feel the fear and you got to do it anyway. That's the moment where you just woke up.
Very, very hard to make money. Very, very hard to find resources. Very, very hard to do anything unless you're a professional.
Finding the courage in the midst of circumstances you can't control. That's the operative phrase.
I'm Alex and welcome to Wise Vibes. On a scale of 1 to 10, how confident are you currently feeling? Our self-esteem is based on how we see and value ourselves. Whether that be because of our appearance, our friendships, relationships, our performance at work, our net worth, in any given situation, how we show up is a clear indication of how confident we are currently feeling. So if you're looking for ways to quickly boost your self-esteem and gain some more confidence, then you've come to the right place. Because today I'm going to be sharing with you 5 secrets toward gaining and improving your self-esteem by 5 incredible people. So let's jump in and get started. Number 1, Be in Charge of Your Thoughts by Mel Robbins.
Now let's talk about the second part of the brain. Drive. That's this puppy right here. This is what you want. This is your prefrontal cortex. Drive is the mode where you're in charge of your thoughts, okay? It's where you are fully awake, you are present, and you are driving your thoughts and actions. When you're doing that, your prefrontal cortex is active. The prefrontal cortex is the part of the brain that you need in order to learn new behavior, in order to do something difficult, in order to do something uncertain, in order to do strategic thinking. So I'm going to give you an example. So I'm a righty. If I were to try to write with my left hand, you know, like Lewis is going to torture me and tie my hand behind my back and make me like do this, I could do it. It would look like I was writing with my foot. And if Lewis came up to me and said, hey, Mel, you want some bulletproof coffee? I'd be like, Lewis, I'm trying to concentrate. I can't do this. My prefrontal cortex would be el fuego because it is firing on all cylinders to communicate to my hand new behavior. So the thing that's cool about that is that you can use a simple trick. The moment you feel yourself hesitate, the moment you've got one of those moments where you know that you need to, this is that moment that Lewis talks to you about where you got to step outside of your comfort zone and you've got to lean into your passion and you've got to really take some risks and you got to feel the fear and you got to do it anyway. That's the moment where you just woke up. And now you got a decision to make. Are you going to drift back into the habits or are you going to awaken your prefrontal cortex and drive forward and focus and do something new?
Number 2, Change Your Beliefs by John Azaroff.
If you think about the era that our parents lived, okay, Great Depression, right? Very, very hard to make money. Very, very hard to find resources. Very, very hard to do anything unless you're a professional. So our parents said to most of us, if you don't become a professional, you're going to struggle. You're going to struggle and suffer. And even the professional said, okay, so become a professional and here's your ceiling of what you have. So we became conditioned to be worried of scarcity in a world that has no scarcity. We became conditioned to having certain beliefs about what's possible or not possible. So even now, you know, we're sitting here and we've got this, you know, amazing election time.
It's crazy.
You know, one of the things I've been thinking about is, you know, there are some people that believe that if Donald Trump wins, they're going to make a fortune. And there's other people that think they're going to lose everything. And I have a friend of mine who has got about $70 million in the bank that believes that if Hillary gets into office, he's going to lose millions. Wow. It's going to be really tough. And what really is, you know, going on in people's heads, it's all of their references, their beliefs and their perceptions that are locked away in the implicit part of their brain that is driving those thoughts and even the behaviors.
They may not even be aware of it.
They're not even aware of it, yeah. They can be, but they may not be. And so what we really have to go back to focus on is it really makes no difference who becomes president or who doesn't. If you have the belief that regardless of what happens in your external world, you can navigate towards the success that you want.
Right.
That's a belief. And beliefs are the lens by which we actually see the world and by which we behave. And so if you want to change your results, don't focus on changing your behaviors. Change your focus on the beliefs that drive your behaviors. right?
And if you're enjoying these videos so far, make sure you gain some confidence right now by hitting that like button below and making sure to subscribe to this channel so you get notified every time another incredible video comes out. Let's jump back into it with number 3, Give Love by Gabby Bernstein.
Very important lesson that's something I've been applying in my own life. And a girlfriend of mine called me yesterday and she said that she was feeling really attacked and judged by someone at work. And my response was, don't defend yourself, don't fight back, don't judge back. Your work, I said to her, is to, the moment that you feel judged and attacked, do something immediately to make somebody else feel loved. So when you feel as though someone has attacked you, judged you, bullied you, done anything to make you feel inadequate or unlovable, do the opposite. Do the exact opposite. Go and do something to make other people feel good. So go make somebody feel lovable, adequate, and good enough. And that simple practice of just taking yourself out of the knee-jerk reaction to fight back or defend, but instead to go give love, that can change everything for you. So I wanted to give you this message. I'm going to have to hang up on you in a moment because I'm going to make dinner. But that is my lesson for you today. When you feel judged, immediately go give love. Go do something kind. Do something compassionate. Do something loving. That will be the quickest way to stop the momentum of the negative energy. There are way too many haters out there. There's so much negativity. There's so much bullying. And there's so much attack and judgment. And that's why I wrote an entire book about this topic. So my hope for you is that when you feel judged or attacked, instead of attacking back, you go give love. You do something to make somebody feel good. You do something that's based in compassion and love and joy. You make someone feel good about themselves. That is my message for you today. I hope it serves you. I love you guys. Thank you for joining me here. And share this video. If you feel like someone else can be supported by this message, go share this video. This is an opportunity to give someone a perceptual shift. If they feel as though they're being attacked by others or put down by the world, this is the greatest way to reverse that momentum and create some change. And we have to change the energy by changing our own behavior and our own reactions. So do it. Do it. So share this video if this serves you. And my prayer for you all is that you feel loved and you feel connected. And at the very least, you know that I love you all. I'm sending you so much love. I want nothing more than for my readers and the people listening and watching to feel loved and feel connected. If you ever feel uncomfortable, come to this page and know that I am here supporting you, loving you, praying for you, and giving you so much energy and that I'm your friend. If you feel like somebody's bullying you or nasty to you, I'm your friend. I'm here for you. I love you. I love you. I love you. I think you guys are fierce and awesome and you're beautiful and you're powerful. And I just hope you can hear my affirmations coming through this Facebook now. You are awesome. You are amazing. And if anybody harms you or makes you feel bad about yourself, go do something to make somebody else feel good about themselves, because that is how we stop the momentum of negative energy and create a new stream of well-being and flow of love that is our duty. It's our birthright. It's our mission.
Number 4, Move and Meditate by Marie Forleo.
I've been through a series of traumatic events and suffer from depression. I live in Iraq and my country has been in war for decades. I'm an architect and love my job. But here, everything you care about or build can be destroyed at any moment. That's if you manage to survive. So here's my cue. How can I find the courage to continue building, knowing all my hard work can be wiped away due to circumstances I can't control? Loving what I do for a living has become a kind of cure to me. I know you say everything is figure outable, and I profoundly share this belief with you, but it's so hard to do on my own. Thanks for giving me a chance to get help for myself and whoever is going through a similar situation. Lots of love to you and your team. R. R, thank you so much for reaching out. Your words went straight to my heart. We have viewers in 195 countries, and I do my very best to stay conscious of the fact that many people like you are living in conflict zones amidst extraordinary challenges. You know, right now I'm in New York, and it's hard to fathom the fear and turmoil and uncertainty that you experience on a daily basis. My heart goes out to you, and I want you to know that we are sending you love, and my hope is that something we share today can help you feel supported and find a sense of strength. You mentioned something really, really important when you talked about finding the courage in the midst of circumstances you can't control. That's the operative phrase, circumstances you can't control. You're living an amplified version of that, but you're 100% right. For all of us, so much of what happens in life is completely beyond our control, and that can leave us feeling powerless. But here's the good news. There's one thing that we have just a smidget of control over, and that's ourselves and how we choose to direct our thoughts and our words and our actions. Keeping this in mind, when I read your question, there were two key habits that I wanted to recommend for you. Both of these can be done anywhere. They don't cost anything, and they're both scientifically proven to help improve depression and anxiety and the impact of trauma. Habit number one, daily meditation. So meditation is the ultimate technology for creating peace from the inside out. For me, it's what helps me stay connected to the loving and strong parts of myself and observe my circumstances without getting swept away by them. Now, we've done a whole episode on this one already, which includes a free 10-minute guided meditation made by me. So if you're willing, I invite you to watch that episode and meditate for at least 10 minutes a day for the next 7 days. And then I want you to write to me at info@marieforleo.com and let me know what, if any, impact it's made. Habit number two is movement. Now, what's tough about this one is that when we feel depressed or we're under extreme mental anxiety, we don't feel motivated to do much of anything besides maybe eating some chips, or in my case, you're really craving some mac and cheese. However, exercise is scientifically proven to be especially effective for depression. You don't even have to get fancy. You don't have to go to a gym. You could run, or you could work out in your house. You know, there are a ton of free videos on YouTube that just use your body weight, so you don't even need any equipment.
Number five, Don't Be Ashamed of Your Past by Oprah Winfrey.
Came from very modest circumstances. You didn't come from a wealthy family.
Well, modest is not the word.
Well, I was trying to be polite.
I mean, I was actually poor. And I, you know, a lot of the girls at my school, actually all the girls from my school are poor. And I was saying to them just recently, I was just in South Africa for a graduation, you know, you all are come from the same circumstances. You were poor. And one of the girls raised her hand and said, I don't like using that word. I go, well, if you're not poor, then you should excuse yourself, because that's why I'm paying for you, because you're in this school. So if you're not poor, you don't like the choice of the word. So I don't have a problem with the word. I don't have any shame about it. I think, you know, probably earlier in my life or career, the word would have bothered me. But it truly was, I was poor. No running water, David, or electricity, living with an outhouse. Okay, that's poor.
Let me know in the comments below what lessons you've connected to the most and how confident you are now feeling on a scale of 1 to 10. And if you know anybody who can use that boost in their self-esteem, then make sure you send this video their way so they can improve their confidence as well. And now I want to leave you off with this powerful quote. The world will never value you more than you value yourself, by Bill Mazur. This is such a powerful quote because at the end of the day, you deserve to understand how incredible of a person you are. You are valuable, you are worthy, you are resilient, and you are enough. I want you to really let those words set in right now. Take a deep breath and repeat them to yourself 3 times. Allow yourself to truly believe it, because at the end of the day, we both know that you deserve it. I really hope you are able to gain so much transformation out of these videos today, and I'm looking forward to seeing you next time. So make sure you click that video up here or down below over here. Thanks again for sharing your time and energy with me, and I am sending tons of love your way.